Rap groups that broke up, part two. Like with any breakup, when it first occurs, the fresh wound stings. But as time passes, we learn to accept fate. Over the past few decades, exceptional hip-hop groups have come and gone. Some of them stopped producing music together due to nasty feuds, lawsuits, and others decided to split up because they knew their music had run its course. Here is our second video on rap groups that broke up. But before we begin, kindly subscribe to our channel for more of our amazing content. Please give us a like, share the video, and don't forget to turn on the notification bell for timely updates of our latest uploads. Let's get it on! Number 1. Grandmaster Flash and the Furious Five. Grandmaster Flash and the Furious Five were a hip-hop group that originated in the South Bronx in 1978. The group comprised of DJ Grandmaster Flash and five rappers, including Melle Mel, Kid Creole, Cowboy, Mr. Ness slash Scorpio, and Raheem. Their elaborate stage shows incorporating turntablism, breakbeat DJing, and choreography contributed to the early inception of hip-hop music in mainstream culture. The group took off in popularity with their first single, Freedom, in 1980 through Sugar Hill Records. In 1981, they released The Adventures of Grandmaster Flash on the Wheels of Steel, a multi-deck live recording which was the first time scratching and turntablism was recorded on a record. Their debut album, The Message, dropped in 1982 and featured the singles It's Nasty, Scorpio, and the title track. This album remains one of the most well-respected collections in the history of hip-hop music. The next year, the group sued Sugar Hill Records for $5 million in unpaid royalties. This lawsuit eventually resulted in the group parting ways, with Melle Mel leaving, followed by Cowboy and Mr. Ness slash Scorpio. During this time, Melle Mel released his own album, Grandmaster Melle Mel and the Furious Five, while the remaining members of the original group added three new members and operated under the name Grandmaster Flash. In 1987, the original lineup reunited and released their second studio album, On the Strength, in 1988. This album was not as well received as the first album, which led to the group disbanding, although on occasion, members from the group have gotten together to collaborate over the years. Number 2. Leaders of the New School. Charlie Brown, Dinko D, Cut Monitor Milo, and Busta Rhymes were all members of the hip-hop group Leaders of the New School. The East Coast group formed in 1989 in the Uniondale, New York area, where the majority of them were from. They had their big break opening up for Public Enemy, where member Chuck D gave Busta Rhymes and Charlie Brown their monikers. The first time they appeared on a record was on an Elektra Records compilation, Rubaiyat, which was released in 1990 to celebrate the record label's 40th anniversary. They contributed a cover of the track Mount Airy Groove, originally done by the jazz group Pieces of a Dream. The group released their debut album, A Future Without a Past, in 1991, which included hit singles Case of the PTA, Sob Story, and the International Zone Coaster. The album received praise for its take-back to old-school hip-hop. In 1993, they released their final album, TIME, with the acronym standing for The Inner Mind's Eye. It contained the single What's Next, which hit number one on the Billboard Hot Rap Singles chart that year. Soon after the release of this album, the band disbanded after issues arose after having creative differences. The last time the group collaborated was on Rhyme's 1996 debut, The Coming, on the track Keep It Moving. They also reunited in July 2012 to perform a few tracks during Rhyme's headlining set at the Brooklyn Hip Hop Festival. Number 3. Fugees. The Fugees came onto the hip-hop scene in the mid-1990s and comprised Lauryn Hill, Wyclef Jean, and Praz Michel. Jean and Michel are Haitian, and Hill is American. This mixture of backgrounds influenced the genres included within their music, which had elements of hip-hop, soul, and the Caribbean, mostly reggae. The name of their group is derived from the word refugee. They recorded their debut album, Blunted on Reality, in 1994. The album contained three singles, Boof Baff, Nappy Heads, and Vocab. Their second album, The Score, was released in 1996 and included one of their most popular songs, Killing Me Softly, along with other singles such as Fujila, Ready or Not, and No Woman, No Cry. Both albums conveyed political messages, with their second album receiving more commercial success than the first. The group disbanded in 1997, but in 2005 did reunite for a European tour. Number 4. Floetry. Floetry was an English duo comprised of Marcia Ambrosius, the songstress, and Natalie Stewart, the Floetist, that was formed in 1997. At first, they started out performing on the poetry stage, then branched out into music, and their music contained R&B, neo-soul, and hip-hop elements. The duo released their debut album, Floetic, in 2002, spawning the singles Say Yes, Getting Late, and the title track. This album peaked at number 19 on the Billboard 200 chart. After the success of this album, the group released their live album, Floecism, which featured the single Wanna Be Where You Are. Their final album, Floology, was released in 2005 and produced the two singles Superstar and Lay Down. The group split when Ambrosius left in 2007 to pursue her solo career. Number 5. Digital Underground. Digital Underground was an alternative hip-hop group that formed out of Oakland, California. Greg Shock G. Jacobs, also known as Humpty Hump, was the leader of the group, which was also comprised of Jimmy Chopmaster J. Dright and radio DJ Kenneth Kenny K. Williams. The group also featured an array of members along with the aforementioned three over the years, including Tupac Shakur and Saphir. Following the release of their successful lead-off singles, Do What You Like and The Humpty Dance, the group dropped their debut album, Sex Packets, in 1990. They released six additional albums after this, which included Sons of the P, 1991, The Body Hat Syndrome, 1993, Future Rhythm, 1996, Who Got the Gravy, 1998, The Lost Files, 1999, and Cause a DU Party Don't Stop, 2008. Shortly before the release of their final album, Cause a DU Party Don't Stop, the group decided to go on an indefinite hiatus. On May 18, 2010, the Greenlight EP was released, which included previously unreleased tracks from the group. On November 13, 2012, the group reunited to give a surprise performance at Flux Nightclub in San Diego. Number 6. Beastie Boys. The Beastie Boys formed in New York City in 1981. Originally, the group started out as a four-piece hardcore punk band featuring Michael Diamond, Adam Yauch, Kate Schellenbach, and John Barry. In 1982, Barry quit the band, and Adam Horovitz replaced him. After the group released their experimental hip-hop 12-inch Cookie Puss in 1983, they made their foray into the hip-hop scene in 1984. That same year, Schellenbach quit the band, which led to the ultimate long-term lineup of the band, which included Michael Mike D. Diamond, vocals and drums, Adam MCA Yauch, vocals and bass, and Adam Ad-Rock Horovitz, vocals and guitar. In 1986, the group released their debut album, License to Ill, which spawned several singles, which included Hold It Now, Hit It, The New Style, Paul Revere, Brass Monkey, You Gotta Fight for Your Right to Party, No Sleep Till Brooklyn, and Girls. Following the success that erupted from that album, they released seven more albums over the years: Paul's Boutique, 1989, Check Your Head, 1992, Ill Communication, 1994, Hello Nasty, 1998, To the Five Boroughs, 2004, The Mix-Up, 2007, and Hot Sauce Committee Part 2, 2011. During the recording process of their album Hot Sauce Committee, which was the planned album that was supposed to be released before Part 2, Yauch announced the postponement of the album due to the discovery of a cancerous tumor in his parotid gland and a lymph node. Even though Part 1 never saw the light of day, Part 2 was technically released on time. The Beastie Boys were inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame on April 14, 2012, although Yauch was too sick to attend. On May 4, 2012, Yauch finally succumbed to cancer at age 47. Mike D told Rolling Stone later that same month that they would likely end their reign as the Beastie Boys after Yauch's death, but he was open to making music with Ad-Rock in the future. There we go! Did you enjoy our video? Which of these groups was your favorite, and why? Well, if you enjoyed our video, be sure to subscribe to our channel for more of our amazing content. Please give us a like, share the video, and don't forget to turn on the notification bell for timely updates of our latest uploads. We value your feedback. Feel free to share your thoughts with us in the comments section below.